said that you're a candidate for governor. So you're planning to run.
No, I'm not planning to run. I am a candidate.
You're running now.
I'm the first somebody to put my hat in the ring. I'm a Republican candidate for governor. No, I'm not a rhino. I'm not an establishment. I'm not a weak Republican. I'm somebody that speaks for the people and will be a voice for the people, whether you're on the left, the right, or whatever you want to call it. I'm going to speak for you. My administration will not govern at night. When we get ready to sign something, this is what we will do. We will send out to the public for 2 to 3 weeks, maybe a month, and let the public decide before I put my signature on before it comes out.
Can you tell me what the top items in your campaign are? What are the main issues for you?
Medical freedom is number one. Taxes, crime, the crime and economy goes together. Without getting the crime under control, the economy is absolutely no good. We're not going to entice anyone to move their business to the state of New York because of crime. Not going to bring their people here. The taxes are too high. We need to give tax break and entice companies to come here. We need to allow fracking. Fracking is safe now. If you do your research, the piping and the wells have been totally restructured. So it's time to open up the economy and have our people to make money throughout New York State. I've been speaking to farmers. What we are doing in New York State, importing goods from other states and everywhere else, and our farmers of the state are suffering. It's time after that. It's time to become New York first. Then if we need additional items, we will then look outside and bring those items in. But I'm here for the people of New York State first.
To address the economy, are there changes that you would make to, for example, the tax structure?
Well, as you know, governor can't make those changes, but what I can do, I can put what the legislature said to me in my fist and say I'm not going to sign until we do something about these taxes. Taxes are too high. People cannot survive as they are now. And the reason taxes are so high because we are taking care of other countries' citizens, illegal aliens. We have over, I would say now, probably about 1 million illegal aliens throughout the state of New York. Most of them, they're not coming here for the farms because we don't have many farms. So most of them, we are taking care of them. We are getting them shelter. We are educating them. We are educating their children. And this is why our taxes are so high. We are ripping off the New York State citizen in order to take care of illegal aliens. As you know, the City Council of New York City just voted to allow over 800,000 non-citizens to vote in our election. I did file a lawsuit against that. I'm challenging it. I'll file a cease and desist order or show cause order in a judicial intervention. That is in the courts now, and we're going to see where that's go because the New York State Constitution clearly says you have to be a resident of the state of New York in order to participate in our election. 18 years of old. It's clear in the New York State Constitution. I'm sure that the State Supreme Court of New York State will strike it down even if the mayor signed it into law.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And what about the crime issues? What kinds of changes would you support to address those problems?
As a guy with a criminal justice degree, I have zero tolerance for any kind of law breaking. It has nothing to do with color. It has nothing to do with groups. But any crime against anybody, it's a hate crime. I don't group people out and say, well, it's hate against Jewish community, hate against the Asian community. A crime is a crime, and it is a hate crime. So I will crack down totally. The current situation now is it's out of control. I will bring the National Guard up to work with my state police. I will talk to the males around the state of New York. If they need the help of the guard, we will deputize them and we will have them working with the police to get crime under control. The bail reform must be overturned. It must go. It's a lot of things ingrained into our system that I don't like, such as the New York Safe Act. I want my people the Constitution to carry in New York State. If I'm carrying, and you see them carry, you're not going to attempt to bother me at all. And the same with young ladies. You're not going to try to rape the woman you see she has a gun. The crime rate will fall. No person is going to challenge somebody with a gun like that, knowing that their life will be in danger. So this is common sense policies, things that have to be done in New York State. And also on the state income tax, I want to wipe it out. I really want to fight to get rid of state income tax. I want to mirror Florida and Governor DeSantis on his policy in the state of Florida.
Are there any other major policy changes that you would like to make?
There are several, too many to name. As you know, the state constitution do not have the right to life in it. We do have a constitutional Congress coming up in the year 2027, and I want everybody to get on the board and push for the right to life to be in our state constitution. It's something that must go, and I will advocate for that as governor. Term limits is a must. We need governor for 2 term limits and out the door you go. We don't need that. We need that. take money out of politics. This is why we're getting tyrants in leadership position, because money is in politics, and when money gets into politics, we no longer govern for the people, we govern for whoever dropped the biggest bag.
What about the relationship between the governorship and the mayor of New York City? That with de Blasio and Cuomo, that was a very contentious relationship. Of course, we have Eric Adams coming in now. He's a Democrat. You're running on a Republican ticket.
Right.
What would you like that relationship to be like?
I would like to have a good relationship with whoever mayor New York City. But if they going left, like I see Eric Adams saying that he's going to go with the same policy de Blasio is going with on the mandates, that's not going to work for me. So I can't work for anybody like that. The governor has the power to remove the mayor when he overstepped, and these things need to be done. We need to bring recall back, which I will advocate to, so we can move these tyrants out of office. Regardless of whether you're Republican, Democrat, Libertarian, you need to be removed if you're not being beneficial to the people. So, yes, I'm fighting to do that. Hopefully Eric Adams changes mind and do opposite of what he says he's going to do. I like that he's law enforcement guy. So maybe he will untie the hand of our law enforcement so they can uphold the laws that we ourselves put in place. And it's something else I want to say. Our police is not the problem. I came from a family of police officers and military guys. That is not the problem. Our police are simply hired personnel to enforce what we the people put out there as laws. If you have a problem with the laws, and this is directed at Black Lives Matter, if you have a problem with the laws, it is not the police you have a problem with, it is the state legislator. Yes, they are unjust laws, and we need to challenge our state legislator, and I want them to join in. It's about the only thing I agree with them, the justice system is corrupt. It's 100% corrupt, and we got to restructure the justice system. So I would like for them to join in and challenge the state legislator and get these things done. But other than that, on the issue of BLM, I agree with absolutely nothing they stand for. God created every man on this earth, black and white. They are using division to bring socialism and communism into our country. As a black America, I'm not from Africa. I'm from the United States of America. This land belongs to me. That's the will of anybody else that's a legal citizen in the United States of America.
When you say that you agree that the justice system is corrupt, can you point to some things that
100%
are
corrupt? I look at what the FBI is doing and the Department of Justice is doing and how they pick and choose who they want to prosecute. If you have money, you can get by with a lot of things. As a black man, and I don't play the race card, I can tell you I've been on both sides of the law as a teenager. I've been on both sides of the law. It is corrupt. 100%. The prosecutors are corrupt. Nobody's being held accountable. Prosecutors, judges, and all should be held accountable. The CPS, family court, is a disaster. Rudy Giuliani put that in place, and it was good when he put it in place, but it has been taken totally left. It's kidnapping children. The judge is not listening to both sides and just making orders. I am fed up with that also. It needs to be dissolved. The Board of Education needs to be dissolved. It has outlived its purpose. We only have indoctrination camps throughout the state of New York and throughout America. I'm fed up with it. I'm insulted every time I hear that let's dumb down the school system so that black kids can catch up or whatever, however they want to look at it. That's an insult to me. Like, I'm not smart enough to be just as smart as that Asian or that white person. It's insanity, and it's not helping my community at all, and I want to help my community. I want the gifted program to stay in place, which they should. Mayor de Blasio's daughter benefit from that. He want to move them out. Because the same one screaming that they love the black community are the same one doing policies that are detrimental to my community. In the heights of Black Lives Matter, they spent tons of money painting on the street Black Lives Matter. That does nothing for the black community. President Trump was doing tangible things for the black community. Renaming streets and painting on the streets doing nothing. We got homeless people everywhere. We got homeless veterans. And this is what we need to be concentrating on. We don't need to be concentrating on moving Thomas Jefferson statue from the New York City Hall. It's insanity. Our past is our past. We embrace it. We learn from it and keep going. It's nothing incarcerating myself but me, my mind. I'm not oppressed. I'm not depressed. I'm none of that. But I can be if I think as a victim. I've never been a victim. I have 2 degrees, one in automotive technology and one in criminal justice. So I've done well. I own my own properties. I own my own land. And everybody else has the opportunity in America to do the same.
A lot lot of people who are talking about education reform point to the fact that there are disparities in test results and in educational achievement between different racial groups and ethnic groups. What is your approach to addressing those disparities, like especially in New York City?
Like I said, dissolve the Board of Education, put it back in the municipality, the cities and towns. You know what's best for your town and your city. Yes, we should have a standard, and that standard should be reading, math, the basic, and government, teaching the American tradition, our American values. We should not succumb to people that is coming across the border and take up what they think should be done in this country. This country was built on our Christianity, the family, and we just got to keep it alive. We got to keep America, America. We welcome everybody here as long as you come the legal way. I have absolutely no problem with that. Come here legally. Don't come across that border and try to jump in line and think that you is entitled to the right that's me as a born United States citizen. You are not.
Any final notes you'd like to add for voters?
I would love for the people watching this to go to my website, Gibson4Governor.com. I want you to go and leave your email address, your information, and let's build a coalition. Let's get we the people in office so you can govern for yourself. And one more thing I left, I did file a lawsuit in the past week against the New York City Council. Mayor de Blasio directed to mandate private business mandate that employees get the jab. That's a no-no. That's illegal. I also filed against the New York City Council for voting to allow 800,000 illegals to vote in our election. So support me. I have a GoFundMe. Support me in any kind of way you can. I'm in the streets. I'm fighting when you're asleep. I never get tired. I keep pushing and I'm fighting for you. I'm fighting for your voice.
Thank you very much for talking with me.
Thank you for the interview.